Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll show you how to design a call history UI by customizing the React list view components header, list items, and group header using templates. Let's get right to the coding part. I will open my existing application, which already has the Syncfusion React Lists package installed. On the app.tsx page, I have included the basic list view rendering code. If you need to know how to create a basic React list view, you can refer to my getting started video link in the card above or in the description below. With this code, you can view the call history. Let's take a quick look at the data I have bound to the data source property of the list view. The group data has the fields like text, ID, icon, type, group, etc. I have mapped the ID and text fields to the field settings. Let me run this application and show you the output. Looking at the list view, it displays the names mapped from the data source. First, I'll show you how to customize the list view header using the header template property. Before customizing the header, I will show the header in the list by enabling the show header property. Add header template property and assign the method custom header. I declare a method custom header and design the template. In the template design, I include span tag and provide the header text as call history. Then assign a class name eHeaderText to this span element. In the app.css page, I write the styles like color, background color, and few others to align the header section. I also include the styles, font size, and line height to the header text. See here, the header has been customized based on the template. Next, I'll show you how to customize the list items using the template property. I'll add the CSS class property and assign the built-in class name, eListTemplate, to the ListView component, which is mandatory for template rendering to differentiate it from normal rendering. Add the template property and assign the method CustomItems. I declare a method CustomItems and will design the template items with icons. Here I'm going to show three things: icon, list item header, and list item content. Include the content division tag. Add the built-in class name eListWrapper, eListAvatar, eListMultiline. I must add class name eListWrapper to the template wrapper element to differentiate between normal and template rendering. I add eListAvatar to the template wrapper element for avatar customization and eListMultiline built-in class for multiple line customization. You can check other built-in classes in the UG link provided in the description below. Then add the span tag with the class name eAvatar, eIcon. In the app.css page, I will write the font face CSS rules to specify the icon details like font family, source, etc. Then assign this font family to the list view icon and specify the icon content. Add another span tag with the class name as eListItemHeader and display the list item header text, accessing it from the text field in group data. In the app.css page, I'll write the font size, font weight, line height, etc. Check now, the list item is rendered with an icon and a name. I will align these items properly after adding its content. I add another span tag with class name as eListContent and provide the list content, accessing the call details with time from props variable. In the app.css page, I'll write the styles like color, font size, font weight, line height, etc. for the list item content. Look at the list view now. Icon, name, type, and time of the call have been added to each list item. Finally, I will show you how to customize the group header. Let me group the list items by mapping the group by field in the field settings. Here, I will group the list data based on the category field. So I'll map that field to the group by property. Check now, the call history is grouped based on the category field. Now, I include the group template property and assign the method custom group template. Inside this method, I add the span tag with class name as eCustomGroup and group the items by accessing the category field from the props variable. In the app.css page, I define the color as Dodger blue for the group header text. Check now, the group header is customized based on the template. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to customize the list header, items, and group header using templates. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.